Now we're moving on to our next session, which I'm sure is going to be as interesting as this one. And the session is very relevant to our current challenges that we all face in organizations. It's about rethinking methodologies of leadership development, a digital imperative. And this session we've designed in a very beautiful format of a bite-sized conversation. So in case you have questions, before I introduce our speakers, I will just share the Slido code for this session. The Slido code is LNDT2S3. So please keep pouring in the questions on Slido. And now to move on to our session. In this session, 2017 Brandon Hall Awards winners Kotak and KNOLSKAPE will present the new age digital methodologies they adopted for leadership development. And to present this session, ladies and gentlemen, we have with us Sethu M, SVP Growth KNOLSKAPE. As the business head for India and Middle East, Sethu Meenakshi Sundaram leads KNOLSKAPE's effort as it expands its offerings geographically. And joining Sethu for this session, we have with us Priya Mehta, AVP Organization Capability L&D, Kotak Life Insurance. Priya leads L&D for the TIED channel at Kotak Life, along with some critical OD initiatives such as employee engagement, senior leadership pre-hiring assessments, potential assessment, and PMS implementation. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Sethu and Priya as they join us on stage. Over to you.
Hello, am I audible? So good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sethu, and I'm SVP Growth for KNOLSKAPE. And I have with me Priya Mehta, AVP for Organization Development at Kotak. So interesting. So about a couple of years back, KNOLSKAPE and Kotak came together to solve an interesting problem. And this next 20 minutes or so is going to be about what we achieved together as a team that got some global recognition for us. So Kotak was going through a transformative change initiative across the board. And we wanted to help them achieve that, right? So when they come to us, they were talking about a lot of changes in digital and all of that, right? How many of you here heard the word change and digital in the same sentence at least 10 times today? Right? That's everybody that says so, right? So this is exactly what they told. And at KNOLSKAPE, what we decided is, hey, can we take a step back and we see what's not going to change? So we started profiling the learner or the leader they are planning to develop in the process of 18 months. And that's the whole idea behind it. And when we profile the learner, we decided to actually say who the modern learner, the modern employee is, right? And when I say this, I am not meaning a millennial. I am not talking about Gen Y or so. I'm talking about everybody from the 20s to the 50s today, right? That's the modern employee. Why? Because all the modern employees today are distracted, no doubts about that. They are all impatient, and they are all overwhelmed. Now, my question to all of you, do you think it's going to get better in the days to come? Are they going to be less overwhelmed? Are they going to be less distracted? Are they going to be less impatient? No? That's a starking reality, right? This is what is the kind of learner or the modern employee we had at Kotak. Now, if this is going to be an employee, do you think old age traditional methodologies are going to work? The answer is a clear no. And that's why we wanted to come up with a new age leadership methodology for this workforce for whom digital and consumerization of enterprise is the norm, right? While this is 10, I'd like to ask a question right now. How many of you purchased from Amazon? Right? If you think I'm getting a bit, you know, not on track, why I'm asking about a question about Amazon and a model learner, let me connect it for you now. Now, this are the six principles Jeff Bezos of Amazon started Amazon with when he started in the early 90s, right? And if there's one point I'm going to focus on right now, then it's going to be this point number 5 of Jeff Bezos. Base your strategy on things that won't change. What's not going to change in the next 10 years? Now, if you realize, when he started off Amazon, he told there are three things that's going to be constant for Amazon for years to come. Number one, people always want cheaper, people always want faster, people always want choices. Will these three things ever change? The answer is a no. So if these things are never going to change, then how can Amazon actually invest in its R&D and growth over the next 3 decades is what he came up with. That's what all the investments are for. If that is the reality of Amazon, then we know what our reality is, the modern learner. So we decided, the problem statement here, to develop this, there are three stakeholders in any organization: the business, the learner, right at the center, and the fraternity, that's you, the HR and L&D folks. You know what's the new normal, you know what's not going to change. How does it impact to the business? The business for the next 10 years is always going to ask for accelerated leadership pipeline. The business is always going to ask full alignment with business goals. The business is always going to ask for effective engagement. The business is going to ask for scale and cost effectiveness. And this is not going to change the next 10 years in the digital world. Now let's see what's the new normal, what's not going to change for the learners. The learners are highly comfortable with technology and mobile. It's not going to change in the years to come, it's going to get better. And they always want experience over instructions. They don't want to be heard or told what to do. They want to do by themselves and then move forward, right? And what's going to be the new constants for you? You always have a pressure to meet business objectives. It's just going to get better and better. Manage expectations from both sides, that's not going to change. Content and solution explosion is right at what you see, right? You don't have to be content creators anymore. You have to be content curators. And then you're going to have data-driven valuations. Every time you invest the money, how did it result back in numbers? Now, I just want to get a quick pulse check. Do you think this is going to change in the next decade? It's not going to change, right? So we got the entire problem statement of the client ready right now. And then when we went to Kotak, this is what we had to show them after this brainstorming, and that's this. If these are going to be constants, we started with the end in mind. We started what's the goal to be achieved in the first place and not the design. So we wanted to achieve greater innovation, increase value, reduce cost, and sustainable growth. Of course, the promise we made to them is not all four. If you could at least get two of it, hey, we have achieved, right? If that's going to be the outcomes, we started with the first with strategy. So you know what's the constant for business, right? They have to be aligned with business. If that's the scenario, now can we make the leaders of the future align to business first and then move the rest? That's what we did. And interestingly, we mirrored Kotak's actual business model with real numbers into a safe learning environment. I'm going to let Priya explain that when it comes to her. Once people understand business, now we give them the right capability or the ammunition to achieve this business goals. And that's for the learner. And what did they want? Experience and not instructions, right? So we're giving them a safe learning environment to practice before they go back to the real jobs and apply it on real people. And the next, the culture. Once I know as a learner that I know the business and I know I have the ammunition to achieve what I want to, now do I have the right cultural fitment to be there and right there? And for this, KNOLSKAPE did not really directly help Kotak. Rather, we let the Kotak team and Priya and her team actually drive this because they are the holders of the culture in the organization. And that's how we ended up achieving the whole outcome for them. Now, to the context of Kotak, I'm going to let Priya take over from here.
All right, so thank you, Sethu, for that. Just to give you orphan customer database kind of a segment or a channel got added. So what challenge were we posed with was that the business started saying that I don't want my branch manager to just look at the agent equation and start say that I need him to have the ability to be able to look at various levers that he can use to be able to generate his business. I need to be able to look at what is the planning horizon of my person really, because typically life insurance, as it is called, is a business of delayed rewards and delayed punishments. So if you're not able to really capture on one of the business levers in the early months of the financial year, you tend to lose out and you can never catch up on those. For example, recruitment of an agent. If 4 months are gone, they're gone. You can't really do anything about it. And if your equation is based only on hiring a life insurance agent, the business can't really be turned around. Yeah. So those were the business challenges that my channel head posed. What were the challenges that I had in my mind were that the audience that I'm going to cater to is at a significantly high hierarchical level in the hierarchy, where they are all 15 years experience in the insurance industry, who've been trained on team development and business strategy several number of times. So when they walk into the classroom, they either come with a mindset that, you know what, I already know this, it's a 2-day break, let me just go there, see what is going to come, fine. If it works, it's good. They come with a mindset saying, leadership, what are you going to teach me about leadership? You sit at the head office, I manage 40 people on the ground. So you can't teach me leadership, yeah? So those are the mindsets that we were grappling with, and we said we have to introduce something that's very innovative. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to grab their attention, yeah? Also because when the problem statement came to us, we knew that we can't really do with one module or just do one session and then the program is over. It had to be a learning journey. So we looked at a journey of about 18 months to 2 years. And we said we are going to have 5 different modules that answer the 5 competencies that we need to talk to. So the first module really had to be something that sets the journey up for success. And what will intrigue the business head better than saying that I'm going to give you a tool that will enable your people plan better. Yeah, so then that kind of quickly gets you the buy-in. In the previous session, we heard a few things about what do you do to be able to get buy-in? What do you do to be able to get your business partner, HR, to get aligned? So some things I might be able to kind of answer here. So to get the business head's buy-in, I said, okay, we will need to look at a tool that gets created and gets deployed, which is simple to use, but also helps really solve the problem of how do I use multiple levers of business to get business, and how do I increase my planning horizon? And that's where KNOLSKAPE really stepped in. I will talk a little bit more about the simulation on the next slide, but what we really did was that we broke down the learning intervention into classroom sessions and followed them by one-on-one coaching for all the people. So I'm talking about 90 people being coached one-on-one for 6 months, which is the interim of the module. These coaches were all internal coaches. So helping those coaches really learn coaching, understand coaching, converting your competency behaviors into the business behaviors that they understand, all of that is what the L&T team had to do, because otherwise you're not talking to the business team really. You're just talking competency and you're talking the L&T language which they don't understand. So what we really did was converted the entire competency framework into a business language, which was very easy for a business manager to understand. We got them to be trained on how do you really do those conversations. There were conversation templates that were created. We used to have frequent train the trainer programs for them every month, once in 15 days, once in 20 days, where the business head was actually speaking to them over a call or let's say a webinar or something like that, and he was actually sharing what is the expectation that he has out of those coaching dialogues. They were getting monitored, dashboards, all of that was happening, which really helped to see if the business impact, the business behavior that you want to see change, is it really changing or not changing? Because if you have 90 people who are talking something and doing something which is similar to, and not similar to what they had done, but in line with what you want them to do, it's quite a clear indicator that the learning intervention has impacted them. Yeah, so that's what we tried to do. We measured business impact more often than not, and we also gave them structured feedback which when they came back to the classroom sessions for the next module. Yeah? So that's the cycle that we followed. And the beauty of the first module really was when we tied up with KNOLSKAPE and we said, what is it that can be done to be able to trigger that business thought into my managers? So they were kind enough, KNOLSKAPE team was kind enough to be able to customize their simulation for us.